So last lecture we have seen the first concept of pre-stress concrete, that is stress concept. And in that stress concept, we have calculated the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam at midsection. Okay. So today we are going to see what is next concept in pre-stress concrete beam. Whether you people are able to see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what we have started? See, we have started the pre-stress concrete, and in the pre-stress concrete principle already we have seen what is principle of pre-stress concrete, and then we have started the concept, basic concepts of the pre-stress concrete. So there are three concepts. Already you people are aware. We have taken the lecture, last lecture. So first concept is the stress concept. So first concept is the stress concept, second concept is the strength concept, and third concept is a load balancing concept. Just we are going to revise in 2-3 minutes what we have seen in the stress concept. This is in stress concept we have to calculate the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam at midsection. So first case in stress concept we have taken while analyzing the beam, cross section of the beam, width and depth of beam, and we have placed the tendon, where tendon is placed along the central axis. Means when tendon is placed at this point, how you are going to calculate the stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam. Okay, so already you people know in beam we have seen when pre-stressing force is applied at center, there are stresses in the beam in the concrete. So those stresses, direct stresses and the bending stresses. So direct stresses we have used formula P by A, that is sigma is equal to stress is equal to force upon area. So P by A positive, because the whole beam get in compression when we are going to apply the direct stress at the cross section of the beam. And then we have considered the bending stresses. In bending stresses we have calculated M by Z. As bending stresses are positive and negative both, bending stresses are positive and negative both, so here we have considered the compression at top and tension at bottom. And combined stresses and combined addition of these two, so P by A plus M by Z, so those are the combined stresses, direct stress plus the bending stresses. So net effect here you can see the beam is in compression. Okay, so stresses at top fiber compression of the beam P by A plus M by Z, and bottom stresses P by A minus M by Z. So this first case we have seen and we have solved the problem on this case also. Okay, second case in a stress concept is when tendon is placed with some eccentricity. So here you can see tendon is placed here, eccentricity you can see here with some eccentricity. This is width of beam, this is depth of the beam. Same way we have to get the combined direct stresses first here P by A, then we have to calculate the bending stresses as usual M by Z compression and the tension. Compression, the tensile stresses. Okay, and then this is new stresses in the beam. Okay, in the stress concept, because of eccentricity, what happened when we provide the eccentricity? The tension is at top of the beam and compression is at bottom of the beam. So that's why here this is tension, this is compression. What will happen when we provide? I will explain you in due to eccentricity what will happen with the beam. If this is beam longitudinal section, this is central axis of the beam, and if you are going to provide the tendon, if you are going to provide the tendon with an eccentricity, with an eccentricity of E, if this is pre-stressing force P and P here, which is going to apply on this beam, okay, what will happen due to this eccentricity? Moment will going to generate. okay, from this central axis moment, and the moment going to apply like this, and due to this the beam is going to bend this part in compression. So like this, like this, beam is going to bend like this because application of this pre-stressing force, okay, with eccentricity due to this moment, the beam is going to try to bend like this. So here tension is at top and compression is bottom. So tension we have used sign negative, and for compression we have used sign positive. So that's why here due to eccentricity, you can see here due to this eccentricity, what happened? P into E. Okay, here that things here, the pre-stressing force P into E, this moment P into E, and this moment P into E. Okay, so tension at top of the beam. So here you can see this is negative. This is at top, negative tension, and compression at bottom. So compression at bottom. And combined effect of these three, direct stress, bending stress, and stress due to eccentricity, you can see this P by A plus M by Z, stresses due to the bending and stresses due to the eccentricity. This is negative, okay, because of tension is at top. And at bottom also, bottom of the beam, bottom fiber of the beam, P by A minus M by Z and plus P by Z. So this how we have calculated the various stresses in the beam, top compression fiber and bottom compression fiber. Okay, so after this, now we are going to see today the next concept of pre-stress concreting. Whether I am audible to you people, you can see the screen. Any problem regarding
this? Yes, sir. Yes.
Okay. No problem.
So now you people clear with the stress concept?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So in exam, yes, how you people are going to face the problem? Solve. They are going to give one beam data. Okay, cross section, loading, pre-stressing force, and they are going to ask you people that calculate the stresses of the beam by using these three concepts. Means one problem you have to solve by using three concepts: stress concept, strength concept, and load balancing concept. And this is most important part in analysis of pre-stress concrete. Okay, so now we are going to see the concept number three, that is load balancing concept. And what is meant by load balancing concept, that we are going to see now. So load balancing concept. If you are going to take one typical longitudinal section of the beam, problem asel tar sanga bar ka skin screen tumhala bagtana screen vagere ka, and this beam is subjected with the point load, suppose P. Okay, and here this is central axis. Central axis. Now tendon is placed with some eccentricity here. Tendon is a bent tendon. Tendon is provided like this. So this is pre-stressing force P and P here. We are going to say this instead of P, we are going to call this as W, because already we are going to use the notation P for pre-stressing force. So what happened along with this point load, the beam is having also having the UDL. W can per meter. Okay, so now in load balancing concept, which thing we have to see? In load balancing concept, we are going to balance the load, means this load we are going to balance, and who is going to balance this load? Now, due to this W, if you are going to calculate the movement, so movement because of this W will be WL by 4, as this is simply supported beam. If this is length of beam is L. Okay, as you people are aware that for point load bending moment, we are going to consider WL by 4. Okay, now what happened? This pre-stressing force is going to apply in the beam, and we have provided the tendon as a bent tendon. Here we have given some eccentricity from central axis. Okay, what happened? This component of this, because of this theta here, because of angle here, the component of this pre-stressing force are going to create, and the resistance of the force, this the resistance of component forces are will be like this. So this is vertical, so this is P sin theta, this is P cos theta, and this is here also P sin theta, and this is P cos theta. Now if you are going to see, due to this bent tendon, the two extra vertical forces are going to act upward direction, and what happened, these two are going to counteract this W, this point load, this point load. Okay, and how this they are going to counterbalance this, the counteract this W. So net effect on beam is W minus addition of these two forces, 2P sin theta will be the net downward force. Net downward force, W is equal to. So this is how we are going to balance the load. Okay, so this beam is subjected now. If you are going to calculate the bending moment of this beam, so beam is subjected with how many bending moments? Can anyone tell me how many bending moment? Kutlokule bending moment known? Whether I am audible to you people? Whether I am audible to you people?
Yes, sir.
Tell me, beam is subjected with, this beam is subjected with how many moments? Moment due to point load, I'm going to add, that is WL by 4, and plus moment due to bending UDL. Okay, moment due to the UDL, this UDL. So the moment due to the UDL is WL square by 8. So in load balancing concept, we have to take advantage, which advantage? Of bent tendon. Because of we have bent the tendon, provided the bent tendon, the component of this vertical component of this tendon is going to counteract the vertical load, and the net effectiveness of this vertical load is going to reduce. Okay, intensity is going to reduce, and that reduced value we are going to consider, and then obviously the moment is going, the net moment is going to reduce. So here total moment I'm going to consider M. So W here I'm going to consider net W. If I'm going to consider net W here, so net W will be here, W minus 2P sin theta into L divided by 4 plus W L square by 8. So this is total moment. So this is load balancing concept, that we are going to balance the load by providing the bent tendon. Okay. Earlier we have provided the straight tendon only at central axis with eccentricity. Okay, but now here we have bent the tendon, and because of bent tendon we are getting extra vertical component, and that is going to counteract with the this point load. And obviously due to that, you can see here W minus 2P sine theta, this net W value, the net load is going to reduce. And if load is going to reduce, obviously moment is going to reduce here. And this advantage we have to take in a load balancing concept. Okay, so this is about the load balancing concept. Now, next thing we are going to see here, after this, we are going to solve the problem. How, same thing here, we have to calculate the stresses at midsection, stresses at midsection of the beam at top compression fiber and the bottom compression fiber. Okay, so stresses, how we are going to calculate, same way we have calculated earlier, that if you are going to consider any big beam, and if this is cross section of the beam, and tendon is blessed with an, sorry, with an eccentricity, eccentricity here, we have to calculate the stresses at midsection of the beam at top fiber and bottom fiber. So again here we have to calculate the direct stresses. Direct stresses, we have to calculate the bending stresses, as usual formula which we have used earlier, that is P by A plus for direct stresses and plus minus M by Z for bending stresses. The only change or the new thing here, while calculating the moment in the load balancing concept, we have to reduce the intensity of load due to this vertical component, due to the tendon. And then we are going to solve the problem. We have to calculate the stresses. Got it? What is new thing in load balancing concept compared with the stress concept? Kuni samjhu shakle mala? Kay kalal tumhala? Whether I'm audible? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay, kala second concept kala. Oka simple concept parayacha sangto. Ek beam ahe, jyavar point load ala ahe. Tara mi tumhala kay sangitlo hota, what is definition of pre-stressed concrete? The process in which we are going to develop the internal stresses in a systematic manner, systematic way, so that those stresses, internal stresses, are going to counteract to the external load. So see now what happened, the bending profile due to this point load obviously is like this. Okay, so like the bending moment profile, we are going to provide the tendon, and due to that we are going to get the extra two components, and those are going to reduce the load and those are going to balance the load. So that's why this concept is called as a load balancing concept. Ek varun load hai, point load, tela vertical jar mi tendon state thevla asta ite kay zala asta, koni sangle mala? If I am going to place tendon straight in this case instead of bending, what happen? I will not get that extra components, because this, due to this inclination, I am getting the vertical forces here, components P sin theta, P sin theta. हे दोन्ही मला मिळाले नसते जर मी टेंडन स्टेट ठेवलं असतं तर. आणि हा पॉइंट लोड आल्यामुळे मी काय करतोय, आय एम युजिंग लोड बॅलन्सिंग सिस्टम. ह्या लोडला मला कमी करायचं आहे, एक्सटर्नल लोडला. तर मी त्याला कमी कसं करू शकतो, जर मी टेंडन बेंड प्रोव्हाइड केला इथं इन्स्टेड ऑफ स्ट्रेट, आय एम गेटिंग दॅट टू एक्स्ट्रा कॉम्पोनंट, एक्स्ट्रा इन्क्लिनेशन, इन्क्लाइंड फोर्सेस. ओके, अँड दोज आर गोइंग टू रिड्यूस द टोटल एक्स्टर्नल लोड ऑन द बीम. अँड अल्टिमेटली ड्यू टू दॅट, इफ load is going, net downward force is going to reduce, so load is going to reduce, in that case ultimately moment is going to reduce. And if you are going to put this thing in the this diagram, in this formula, bending stress, we are going to get the stresses is very less. So this is about the load balancing concept. Kala sagana?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we are going to see now the problem, how we are going to apply this thing to the numerical problem that we are going to see now. Are you able to see the screen?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. See, analysis of symmetrical section. We have not seen up till now the unsymmetrical section. Here we are dealing with only symmetrical sections. So prestress concrete members, load balancing concept. And already I have shown in the figure in the just on paper. This thing just I am going to explain. See here, the beam is subjected with the point load, and the bent tendon is bent tendon. Here you can see with the inclination of theta, with the horizontal axis, and this is prestressing force. This is central axis, central line, and net effect. This P is going to act inclined, and due to that, the inclination forces to incline here. Due to this, the vertical force is going to generate. Resistance of this force, inclination, resolution of forces. You have to study it in first year applied mechanics. So here, this component here, P sine theta. P sine theta. This is also P sine theta. P sine theta. And net here, you can see the total addition of these two P sine theta, and this is going to contract. W. Intensity of this force is going to reduce because of this. And this is the why this thing we have got, because of providing the bent tendon. म्हणजे बघा प्रीस्ट्रेस कॉन्क्रीटिंग मध्ये व्हाइल डिझाइनिंग द एनी बीम, तुम्ही प्रीस्ट्रेसिंग बीम डिझाइन करताय, तर त्या केस मध्ये यू पीपल शुड नो विच टाइप ऑफ लोडिंग इज गोइंग टू ऍक्ट ऑन द बीम अँड हाऊ बीम इज गोइंग टू बिहेव इन इन बेंडिंग. So exact first we have to understood that what are the stresses are going to, external stresses are going to act on the beam, and after studying those stresses we have to develop the internal stresses to contract those stresses. Okay, so next here, if I'm going to consider now problem method here, so first thing, the various steps in load balancing concept. The axial longitudinal force provided by the tendon is P cos theta, because inclination here you can see the horizontal force. We can take this force as a P cos theta. Okay, but the P approximately theta is very small. We are going to consider P value. Direct stresses P cos theta. This already I have told you this value is very small. That's why we have to consider P by direct stress. Earlier problem we have seen net bending moment here W minus 2 pi P sine theta into L. This that is a moment value for point load WL by 4, and in this I have subtract this value 2 P sine theta because of the bent tendon profile, and this is due to UDL moment WL square by 8, and the extreme stress fiber stresses at top fiber section P by A plus M by Z, and extreme fiber stresses at bottom of section P by A minus M by Z. So these formulas we have to use, and we have to calculate the stresses in a load balancing concept. So this is typical one problem, numerical problem. In this we are going to calculate the stresses. So prestress, this is problem. Write down. So we are doing the problem. We just solve it. Randomly I am going to check your notebook also. Mr. Sangitle video call karun kuni hai dakwa mala notebook ta problem. तर दिसायला पाहिजे मला त्याच्यामध्ये. रँडमली मी सांगतो दोघा तिघांना. दिसतो सगळ्यांना प्रॉब्लेम डिक्टेट करायचं आहे.
दिसतो.
राईट राईट डाऊन प्रॉब्लेम राईट डाऊन. ड्रॉ स्केच ऑल्सो. प्रॉब्लेम लिहून झाल्यावर सांगा मला. एक दोन मिनिट घ्या टाइम. हेलो रुद्रा मॉड्यूल
यस सर
यस सर
सो आई थिंक यू पीपल हैव रिटन द प्रॉब्लम
यस सर
सो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम प्रीस्ट्रेस कंक्रीट बीम 400 बाय 600 mm सेक्शन 400 बाय 600 mm सेक्शन हैज अ स्पैन ऑफ 6 मीटर एंड द बीम इज प्रीस्ट्रेस टू बी बेंट टेंडन एज शोन इन फिगर सो हियर यू कैन सी The bent tendon is provided. The external load on the beam consists of concentrated load of 150 kN. So 150 kN is a concentrated load at a midspan. The effective pre-stressing force is 1000 kN. So this peak you can see here. Effective pre-stressing force 1000 kN. Calculate the extreme stresses at mid-span section of the beam. So here at this mid-span, we have to calculate the stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. Okay, so first thing we have to calculate the required data, that is pre-stressing force that given, cross-sectional area A, we have to calculate moment and then sectional modulus. So first thing here, let the tendon be at the theta with horizontal. So first we have to calculate this tan theta value. So tan theta is equal to, people know, front side divided by adjacent side. So if I'm going to draw this line here, so front side of this is this, front side of this theta is this, and adjacent side is half of this length of the beam. So this is L by 2. So tan theta, you people know, tan theta. Samoril bazu divided by lagachi bazu. So front side here. So you can see here, below this tendon, they have given distance 160 mm. Total beam is 600 mm. So obviously this value will remain 140 mm. So in front of theta, this value will be 140. So front side is 140 and adjacent total beam is 6 meter span L by 2. So this will be here 3000. So tan theta is here 7 by 150. Okay. So next, the inclined tendon will provide an upward force at mid span. Due to this inclination, the upward force P sine theta, this is P sine theta. Total, this upward force is 2 P sine theta. Since this sine theta, okay, the tan theta is very small, that's why we are going to consider here. That sine theta is very small value, that's why we are going to consider here tan theta. Okay. So we have got the value here, tan theta value, 140 divided by 3000, that is 7 by 150. So now we are going to, if you are going to put the value here, 2p sine theta. So here 2, this is p, pre-stressing force, and this is tan theta. So total force here 93.33. This is upward force. Means here 150 kN is load on beam. And due to this tendon we have provided, the upward force we have got value is 93.33. beam total force hatrela counteract karnaraj aahe tyamule shillak kiti rahela. So only 57.67 force is the effective, manje beam var kiti hota 150 hota, pan ya tendon bend provide kela mhanje je vertical component mulo actually force ala hr only 56.67. next, bending moment due to the net vertical load. So your net vertical load is 57.67 because already we have subtract the 2p sin theta, this value already we have subtract. So bending moment wl by 4, so w you have to put here, wl by 4. So this bending moment value is this, and dead load here, self weight of beam 0.4 into 0.6 into 25. So this is 6 kN/m², and bending moment due to dead load, so due to dead load wl² by 8, so w is 6 and l² by 8, so this is 27. So net bending moment here 84.84 plus 27. This is due to vertical load and this is due to bending moment, okay, due to UTL, so self weight of the beam. So total bending moment here 111.84. B47 अरे म्यूट करत जा रेस, आवाज करत असेल तर तुम्ही आजूबाजूला.